Hi, today I'm trying out the grid method for the first time.
Okay, to do the grid method, first you draw a grid over your entire reference photo. I'm using a ruler so I can make sure all the lines are straight and evenly spaced. I've chosen to make each square a half inch squared. Then you draw an identical grid over the paper you're going to be drawing on. Now, I'm making my grid lines really dark on purpose because I want you to be able to see them. But if you were doing this in real life, you'll want to make those lines super light because no one wants to see a bunch of grid lines on your paper. Okay, now I got both of my grids drawn, and I'm going to go up to the grid on my reference photo, and along the outside edge, I'm going to put A, B, C, etc. And I'm going to do the same thing on the grid on my drawing paper. Now, the idea with the grid method is that I look and see what squares my subject's features fall into on the reference photo and try to put them in the same places on my drawing. That's where those letter-marked squares come in. So for example, the top part of her forehead, right above her eye, starts right at the top of square C and ends at the bottom of square E. But I can already tell it's not going to work out quite that way on mine. The squares on the graph on my drawing paper aren't the same size as those on my reference photo. In case you can't tell, I'm having a real hard time with this. I'm looking at my letters and trying to figure out horizontally where the features line up, and I'm counting squares, and it's just not working. So I think the eye is two squares over from the letter C, and in the right side of the cheek before the jawline is two squares, but I'm gonna have to make it three on mine because the squares on my drawing are not the same size as the squares on my photo, which is not how the grid method is supposed to work. I'm going to try a link to some videos from people who know what they're doing when it comes to the grid method better than I do. Hey, I really wanted to finish the face, but I gotta stop here. I can already tell it's not working out, and I'm just getting too tired and frustrated.
The grid method has never personally appealed to me, but you know what they say, shit knocks something till you've tried it. I think you can guess how much of a role the grid method is going to play in my drawing now. Despite my best efforts, I couldn't make the squares on my reference photo match up to the squares on my drawing, and that was using a ruler and measuring everything. I'm sure someone's going to say, you just need to have more patience, but really, I don't feel like being bothered. While I don't like using the grid method, I do like using horizontal lines. For example, I'll draw a horizontal line from one eye and use that to show me where to put the other eye. And I'll also use horizontal lines when drawing eyes and mouths to help me keep them straight. I'm not going to tell you not to use the grid method. It's obviously very popular and a lot of artists use it and love it. But for me, I guess it's just too mathematical and takes the joy out of drawing for me. So I thought the grid method wasn't for me, and now I know. So those were my results trying the grid method, and I encourage you, even if you don't think you'll like something, give it a try. Some things will work out well, and others won't. Obviously, this didn't work out for me. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. I put out art videos 3 days a week, so if that sounds good to you, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon to turn on notifications. For now, thanks for watching, and goodbye!